The boys are back in town. will flow and blood will spill. And if the boys wanna fight, you better let them. That jukebox in the corner blasting out my favorite song. The nights are getting warmer, it won't be long. Won't be long till summer comes. Now that the boys are here again.
Absolutely delighted, proud, ecstatic, thrilled that the game was such a wonderful spectacle, thrilled that the way they played, that it was a magnificent final. But you've got to say, this is a great team, not a good team, this is a truly a great team, and we should appreciate what we're seeing here. And the championship qualities that so many of those players, Shane Morgan had a magnificent game, Johnny Sexton had a magnificent game, but and just to get Brian O'Driscoll out, it wasn't his best game, but he still stood up, he never quit, and ignited some of those. Rickard Strauss had a very poor first half, was injured, and then had an outstanding second half. And then through it all, their captain Leo Cullen, I think the most underrated forward in Ireland. And the justice has been done because they are the best team in Europe. They've been the best team in Europe all season. They've come through a very, very tough side of the draw. They've beaten the French champions, they've beaten the English champions, they've beaten the European champions, and they played in this game like a champion team. Richly deserved to Joe Schmidt, to all the people, richly deserved.
For the last time I was at the Millennium Stadium for news talking with Mr. Witness Ireland winning the Grand Slam and lifting the Six Nations Championship trophy and lifting the Triple Crown trophy, and again the podium has now been constructed in front of us, right on the halfway line, right in the middle of the field, because Leinster will be lifting that beautiful glistening trophy for the second time in three seasons. Keith, I have to ask you this now, because we are here and we are live, but it'll be easier to do this a week's time when everybody can sit back at distance from this game and try and figure out what the hell went on. But just 5 minutes after the full-time whistle, how can you even begin to explain the difference in the attitude and the performance of the two teams separated by a dressing room door and 15 minutes of a half-time break?
You know, in many ways, it's both sides of the one coin. You know, I have to admit, I think Leinster were off the mark at the start. I don't think they prepared themselves for the physicality that they needed to win a final. I don't think that they thought they had to play at the full 100% that they have done all season to actually win this final, and they were off the mark. In the second half, I thought their attitude was, well, that was gone, because that was thrown in the bin, because it was patently true that if they didn't put every single ounce into it, they were going to get roundly and soundly beaten. And I have to say, I thought Northampton came out in the second half thinking that we've these guys beaten. Yeah, and they're trying to think that, you know, that they don't ever want to have that comment. They don't even want to have that, you know, hear anybody murmur it in the corner of the room. They don't want to ever hear it. But they came out and did not come up on the defensive line once. Did not have any of the oomph, the passion, the absolute great play that they had in the first half, in stark contrast to Leinster, who said, well, to hell with that. We're going to play like we can play. We're going to do all the things that we're going to do, but we're going to do them at 100 miles an hour. We're going to do them basically simple things, but so hard, so physical. We're going to do the damage, and they did the damage. That was a magnificent second half performance.
So, Matty, is it a combination of Leinster completely changing their attitude, realising that if they didn't do something, they'd be beaten at the gate, and also Northampton maybe going back out for that second half, feeling deep in their hearts that the game was won?
Well, I think you've got to say that we always said, or I believe, that Northampton couldn't live with Leinster if they played at what Leinster can do. But the only way they could overcome that was physicality, and they did it. You've got to give them credit in the first half. Let's give Northampton the credit. And they definitely dropped their intensity for the 80 minutes. They couldn't live with the intensity that Leinster brought to their play. And in the first half, it upset Leinster, and you've got to... It's exactly what Keith said, but let's say it, as Victor Kostelag looks at me laughing, it is a great day for the boys in blue. It is a great day to say that champions get up when they can't. Now, let's think of champions team in the past. Let's think of these champions. Let's think of Munster. Let's think of all the great times. They got up when they couldn't. And that's Munster set the bar. Now, Leinster have risen to that. They were its champion side because they were beaten at halftime. I said the truth. I thought they were gone. They had to score next. But to even score next, the performance, the quality, the complete turnaround is truly extraordinary.
Mike Ross in the first half was belittled. You know, in every scrum, he got screwed. He was stood up, he was pushed back, either by legal or illegal means, Matty. You know, and he got absolutely screwed. In the second half, he tore his absolute number apart. He stayed on for the whole game, you know, for until 2 or 3 minutes from the end when Stan Wright came on instead of him. He played incredibly well. But in the second half, he carried the ball 6 or 7 times. You know, there's players that had to stand up, and there was something wrong. They didn't get it right in the first half. They got it absolutely and wholly right in the second half. Sean O'Brien in the second half was astounding. You know, he carried the ball, but he didn't carry it, hit and go to ground. Every time he made contact with an opposite number, he knocked him back in his ass. He carried it about 7 or 8 yards, and in some cases, 15 or 20 yards. And it just makes it so much easier. Everything that...